The first thing I want to discuss is control system. So, what is a control system? In this picture, a control system is symbolized by this frame here, by this box. There is written Steuerung, that's the German word for control. So this should be the control system. A control system has a number of inputs and a number of outputs. The inputs are coming from the outside world and the outputs are influencing the outside world. And which outputs are turned off, turned on, turned lower, turned higher, whatever, yeah, is somehow done by the control system. Based on the inputs, the control system decides by some logic what shall be done with the outputs. Needs, for instance, a heater to be turned on, needs an air conditioning system turned to be stronger because it's too hot in the room, something like this. Yeah? So the control system, the logic inside the control system is looking at the inputs which are coming from the outside world and is turning off, on, or whatever outputs to influence this outside world. That's an automated system. So the inputs can either be digital, this means just on and off, 0 and 1, true or false. The input and outputs can be digital, and the inputs could maybe be analog, so some value between 0 and 100%, let's say. Yeah. And also the outputs can be analog, however, in our PLC or in our control system we are using, it's not real analog, it's just PWM, pulse width modulation. What this is, I will explain later. Yeah, in our control system, the logic, which is somehow deciding what shall be done with the outputs based on the inputs, is done in software. So we are writing a program on the computer, compile it, send it down to our control system, and this is doing the thing. So if and such control systems where this logic is programmed in software is a so-called PLC, a programmable logic controller. Our PLC we are using is not really a PLC. It's a very small one board controller. Yeah. For a real PLC, there's missing for sure the case, the power supply, some solid, really solid screw terminals and so on. So there's something missing, but it's a good practice. Our PLC type is called an Arduino. Okay, Arduino. What's an Arduino? This is an Arduino. This handy little device is nothing more, nothing less than a little PLC. It's everything we need to use it as programming logic controller. The main part is this chip here. Yeah? This chip or this integrated circuit is nearly everything. The rest of the board is not that important. It's mostly connections to the outside world. Yeah. Connections to the outside world. Then we have some USB devices, USB handlers, and we have some power supply, and that's it. The main thing, the real magic is really happening here. Here and this. There is the memory inside, there's the CPU inside, there's everything else inside. That's the system on a chip, a so-called SoC. What we've got here are several connections. On the top end, we have pins, in and output pins, marked from 0 to 13. These are for in and output. 0 volt on these pins means logically false or 0, and 5 volt on these pins means logically true, high or 1. Okay, so the high B level is 5 volt logic. We can use either pin here as input or output. We have to distinguish if we want it as input or output. Some of them are not only able to handle digital outputs, they can only handle pulse width modulation. They can turn on very fast, turn off and on very fast. What means pulse width modulation, we will discuss later. All these outputs which are able to do pulse width modulation are marked with this special sign here. Looks like a minus, yeah, but actually it's a tilde. So this means this pin, if configured as output, can handle pulse width modulation. So all those pins here are in and outputs. 0 and 1 are special pins. Yeah. So we have from 0 to 13, 14 pins. 0 and 1, like I said, are special pins. They are for communication, so we use only from 2 to 13. That's enough. Should be enough for you. Below here, we have analog input pins. Yeah. So the inputs above here can only handle 0 or 5 volt, true or false. Here we can handle voltage levels between 0 and 5 volts. So we can, anything between can be handled by this. So 2.5, 2.7, 4.4, whatever. Yeah. And if you read out these pins, if you read these pins from your in your program, you will get a corresponding number. Yeah, so you don't get true or false, but you get a number between 0 and 1023. So 0 means 0 volt, 1023 means 5 volt, a number between means something between. So there's a 10-bit analog digital converter. Here we have power supply, yeah, power supply part. Some of the pins are marked with GND, ground. There are three. Ground, this means 0 volt reference voltage. Okay, so there is also a 5 volt pin, it's marked with 5V, 5 volt output is here, stabilized 5 volt. We have 3.3 output, 3.3 volt output, and we have 3.3, 5 volt, 2 grounds, and there is only one thing marked as V in. This V in is connected to this input pin. Yeah. The power supply check, it's a standard check. You can supply here the Arduino with some voltage. Wide array of voltage, and you find this voltage also on the V in pin. If you plug in here 9 volt, you find 9 volt. If you plug 12 volt, 12 volt. So there's a wide variance, a power supply variance. You can use from, let's say, 7 volts to 14 volt or even more. Yeah, please refer to the specs. Refer to the specs, what is used here. Yeah. Another possibility is also to use this USB port. The USB port can be plugged into your computer, and this will also power supply your Arduino. So there is no need. There's no need to also use this check. If you use USB, this DC does not have to be used. You can use both, but if you use USB, it's enough. Yeah, the 5 volt pin is directly connected to the USB port, and the power supply, if you use this check, then you have, then these things are going to happen. There is the power stabilizing things, they are producing the 5 volt. There are of course different parts. This here, for instance, is the crystal. It is swinging and is giving simply the duct. Yeah. That's the clock. That's it. That's the Arduino. There on the top is a button. There's a reset button. If you press it, the Arduino will immediately stop executing the program, regardless of what is programmed. If you release it, the Arduino will start again to execute the program. The same we have here on this reset pin. If you connect this reset pin to ground, then the Arduino will stop. If you open the ground connection, the Arduino will start again. So that's our Arduino. With this device we are working. You also have a cable for your device, for this device, a USB cable. There's one side of this USB cable is a and the other end is a USB B plug. Yeah, you can use it to plug in your Arduino to your computer. Yeah, so computer, Arduino, that's it. Plug in here, plug in there on the computer, the Arduino is ready for programming. So that's about the introduction to the Arduino. Next step will be, we will download the software, the necessary software, install our software on our computer, and then we try to put our first logic in our Arduino. Okay. Thank you so far for listening.